Welcome to Ghazali. We have a very special guest today. It is not very often that I get to interview a person whom I have created. I'm going to interview my own son today. Yesterday I saw a cartoon of Dennis the Menace in the newspaper. And Dennis is asking his father, "Father, there is nothing which is very good which has come into me from my father's side. Is everything from mother's side?" Well, the jokes apart, I can definitely claim that my son is definitely carrying forward things I have started, and not just carrying forward, but adding to it. And of course, the mother's contribution is also very, very important. Siddharth Kerkar, he is 21 years old, and he's studying art in London, in Central St. Martin's. He has taken 1 year off, and he has joined Museum of Goa. But what is interesting about Siddharth is, for the last 10 years, he has traveled with me in many parts of the world, and he has already been to Venice Biennale 3 times and been to most contemporary museums, galleries, and festivals of Europe. So Siddharth, you're just 21, yeah, and you are already about to start the Goa's first Goa Affordable Art Fest.
Yeah, I think we've already started it actually, and the response we've got for the Goa Affordable Art Fest has been immense. We got over 740 applications. This is the first time we've actually created an event of such a scale. And I think it has been an absolute success even before the event has actually started.
Before we go to all that, tell me, what gives you the right or the knowledge to be the co-director of an art fest of this kind at the age of 21?
So I think I conceptualized this project. The idea actually came from the Royal Academy Summer Exhibition in London, where we have, it's a platform for emerging artists from around the world to showcase their work in a very supreme space in London. And I thought, why not bring this idea to Goa and India, since we have so much of talent, however, not enough platforms provided for these emerging artists. It shows with the number of applications we've got, which is over 740. It shows the amount of desperation in the emerging artists in India today.
Okay. Now, this things like this, when you said, let's start an affordable art fest, Goa Affordable Art Fest, my previous experience with starting something like this was a little bit poor, because I thought that we will get a few applications, we will not be getting so much. But you managed to get almost 800 applications from around the world. Tell us, what was the strategy you adopted? How did it happen? Tell us in detail.
So, I'd like to tell you that I have not spent a single rupee on the promotion of the art fest. All the artwork was done by me. All the promotion artwork was done by me for the open call. And what I did was basically created a page on Facebook and Instagram. And I followed and commented on people who are connected to art. How I did this was, for example,
not just any people. Which people did you choose?
The people I chose were just random artists that popped up on my newsfeed that I connected with. At the same time, artists that followed important art institutions in the country, like Khoj and the world, like Khoj, Tate Modern, MoMA, then a few really big institutions all across the globe, which have a following of these artists and art collectors.
That was, I think, a very important strategy, because Siddharth started following artists who are following great institutions, Tate Modern and all this, and making comments. So they, in return, followed you.
Followed me back on the Goa Affordable Art Fest account. And that's how they came to know about this. And earlier, let me tell you that this Goa Affordable Art Fest was named Goa Affordable Art Fair. And within the 4 days of promotion that we did, I got an email from the director of the Goa, the Affordable Art Fair, which
in
is
London,
a brand.
In London,
which is a brand. Which is actually based in Hong Kong. I got a message from their office telling me that, you know, we can sue you if you go ahead with this project, which is Goa Affordable Art Fair. So that's why we had to change the name to Goa Affordable Art Fest. And I wrote back to him saying that I'm glad that the message about the Goa Affordable Art Fest has actually reached you even in Hong Kong. So within 4 days of promotion, we had an outreach of this kind. So I was pretty much glad to get an email from
there. Anyway, so Goa Affordable Art Fest is going to be a brand now. And it is definitely a brand which is here to stay.
Yes.
Yeah. So, okay. So tell me, what was, we all selected the artists together. Who were the other people who helped you?
So we had Peter Mueller on board, who is a very important art collector. At the same time, he was a gallerist in Munich. And we also had Subodh Kerkar, who's my dad, on board. And I was also a part of the selection team. So we all sat together and we've done the selection. And we ended up selecting about 170 artists for out of the 740 who actually applied.
My first question you did not answer. Now, you were also in the selection board.
Yeah.
And you did a good job, I must say.
Yeah.
Your contribution was very, very important. But you are in the you have only done the foundation course, the first year course in the Art College in London, and you have been selecting works of artists who have done post-graduation. What gives you that right? So tell me about that.
So I think I am not an amateur in this field. I have traveled the world with you. I have gone to exhibitions like the Venice Biennale about 3 times. I study in London, which is also a great art hub. So I've got the opportunity to actually look at art all over London, all over the world, in fact. And I've actually been creating canvases which are about 6 by 6 feet since the age of 9. So I think I have also in the past 10 years, I have been, you know, exposed to this field, and the understanding has come with it, I must say.
Yeah, I agree with it, because I think it is very important when you want to sort of select music, appreciate music, you have to become a kansen, not just tansen. Kansen. The same way, to select art, you have to become an aksen. And I must say, with so much of exposure, you have achieved that capacity. And that's a very well selected art fair. And I'm very sure that this Affordable Art Fest, Goa Affordable Art Fest, will be of a very high standard and perhaps one of the largest. It's the largest
definitely
in the country.
It's the largest
in the country. How do you feel, I mean, starting the largest affordable art fest in the whole country?
I feel great. In fact, we've not even started it yet. We'll be launching this Sunday on the 17th of December at 6 p.m. Amitabh Ghosh will be the chief guest of the occasion, and he will grace it by attending it. And I think we've already, you know, reached out to the people. We have been flooding the newspapers and the media with our promotion material. We have been. People are talking about us. Even a friend that I have in Delhi, who's actually the daughter of the owner of Delhi Art Gallery, she has heard about it. So people, she has been telling me that she's been hearing about this festival in Delhi within the art group. So that makes me feel great. And
so that's good.
Really,
congratulations.
Reached out there.
Now tell us, why is it important that younger people look at art?
So another inspiration that made me actually come up with this project was because I was invited in Algarve, south of Portugal, for an environmental art fest, and I was hosted by this Swiss lady, and Sylvia, who had given me this small room to stay in. And when I went into her house, the amount of artworks that I saw who are by masters, abstract masters, since I'm very much, my style is very much abstract. And I saw these works, and they are idols of mine. So Serge Polyakov, you have. She had originals of Serge Polyakov.
So basically, what he's trying to tell us is, when he went to this lady's house, he saw works of great abstract artists of the world, which are worth, lakhs of euros. And he wondered how come this lady owns this work, which is so expensive.
Yeah,
and then what happened?
And so I asked her about these works, how do you end up collecting such expensive pieces? And she told me that she collected them when she was 18. And this is a lady who just turned 75 this year. And so the idea of collecting artwork at 18, I felt was amazing. She paid for these artworks for 2.5 years, working extra hours on.
And it was 300 euros.
300 euros back then.
At that time, it was not euros. That euros did not exist. But about $300 or whatever.
Yeah. So it came at a very affordable price at that time. And I thought we should always.
And she also paid for it for 2 years by extra hours.
By working extra hours. So I like that idea of, you know, collecting art at 18, and she saw the potential in the artworks. And what we are doing here at Goa Affordable Art Fest is we are doing a very, very strict selection, because we've only selected out of one out of every five applications, and we are actually serving on a platter artists that we feel have potential to grow, and we have about 1,200 artworks which will be sold, which will be on sale and exhibited at the Goa Museum of Goa. And so this is why I want to urge a younger generation of artists to actually invest in art, instead of, you know, just blowing your money on parties. There's always something you can give back to art. You can also support young talent at the same time.
You just use that word investment in art. I don't particularly like it very much. What message do you want to give to young people who will come? Yeah. Invest in art or
appreciate
something else?
More of appreciating rather than investing, but make it a point to expose yourself to good art. And also another attraction we've done for them is we are also hosting a party after the
Let's come to that a bit later. So coming to this, basically everybody talks about investing in art, but I think it is very foolish to invest in art unless you are able to connect with it. It is very important to connect. If you don't connect, what is the point in just buying something which you feel okay is going to grow? And you are bound to make a mistake. You will never choose the right work of art if you just sort of buy it as an investment. So you have to first fall in love with art, connect with art, understand it, let the art give you goose pimples. Yeah. And when that happens, then you start collecting art.
Yeah.
And then you will be, you will be so happy. You are not going to basically buy it because you are going to sell it in future. You will buy it because you are going to stay with it and appreciate it.
Yeah.
So, okay. So what are the steps you have taken to woo the younger crowd of Goa or younger generation to come here for the affordable?
Yeah. So we have after party planned, which will be pretty grand with about 7 DJs from all over Goa. And they'll be, this is the stage right behind me actually, they're doing the setup. And it's actually, I have had an event manager called Fred D'Souza, who owns a company called Major Milkshake. And he will be taking forward this this party. And I feel this party will also attract a younger generation of people who will, you know, go around the museum, look at art for the first time. Many of them haven't ever come to the museum, including my own friends. So I feel this will also be like a bait to attract them to this Goa Affordable Art.
No, I very much appreciate that, because I think it is very important that younger people connect with art. Because if they don't connect with art, then they lose something. There is something missing in their life. Imagine a life where you don't connect with cinema, with theater, with music, with literature, with poetry. What kind of a boring life that will be? Because essentially what gives us human beings a right to call ourselves human beings, call ourselves civilized, is our engagement with arts. Yeah. But without our engagement with arts, we are like any other animal.
Hmm.
So arts of all kind is what make human beings.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, well, how many people do you expect to come for this?
I expect a crowd of about 1,500 people. The amount of promotion we've done is absolutely massive. Mm-hmm. We have flooded Facebook and Instagram with our posts. I have about 50 shares which I've got through all my friends, and you know, it's really.
I only hope I saw one cartoon.
Yeah.
In I think some newspaper, there's a man dead, and there are a few hundred chairs kept next to his coffin in the church, and there are only two people, and one is asking the other. He had 5,000 Facebook friends.
Yeah.
I hope that something like that does not happen.
Absolutely not.
And they actually come.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah, I think
so, okay.
People...
So, well, I would actually like to make a few... Would you like to say something else?
I would like to ask you, what do you feel about such an event taking place in Goa? And do you think this event of such a scale can get bigger, maybe take it to other places in India? What do you feel about this event also taking place during the Serendipity Art Festival, which is also a massive festival happening in Goa at this time?
I think these days very interesting things are happening in Goa. Serendipity Art Festival is very good. We had a Goa Photo Festival which happened.
Yeah.
We have the Art and Literary Festival which happened in International Center. So slowly very interesting programs are coming into Goa. And this is a very encouraging sign, because I think cultural capital is very, very important, even for tourism. Goa is a tourist state. and cultural entrepreneurship. It is very important. I myself have started a museum of Goa. I think it's something very important also from tourist angle. We have anywhere from 50 to 150 people to 200 people coming every day to the museum. So, and most of them are tourists. So this is very important to invest into cultural tourism, and that's what we have done. And what you have started, Goa Affordable Art Fest, is a step in that direction. And I think it has to grow bigger. And what is most important is, I do not bother, even if nobody buys anything. Of course, we have to sell and we have to make it workable. But what should be most important is everybody from all over Goa should come and at least see. Because that's how we can develop arc saints and enrich their life. See, there is a very important reason why common people do not connect with contemporary art. Most galleries which show contemporary art are in five-star areas, in very posh spaces, and common people are even scared to go and press the bell of the door of the gallery. Because this is not for us, this is for them, the richy rich. So what we are doing is democratizing art, demolishing these cultural barriers and taking art to the masses. So through the medium of Prudent, I would like to appeal, sagaya goykarang sangung sutta ki कला पळोप कंटेम्पररी आर्ट पळोप सामके महत्वाचे जरूर येयात. इट इज फ्री फॉर एवरीबडी एंड सो प्लीज कम हॅव अ लुक एंड अंडरस्टँड वॉट द आर्ट इज अबाउट बिकॉज चडशे मोस्ट पीपल फील दॅट आर्ट म्हटलं कितें तर पोर्ट्रेट म्हटले आर्ट लँडस्केप म्हटले आर्ट कितें फ्लॉवर पॉट काढले कोणी दॅट इज आर्ट बट देर इज अ लॉट ऑफ अदर थिंग्स विच ऑल्सो आर पार्ट ऑफ दिस आर्ट सीन एंड what we are doing is giving this on a platter to the common people. And that's what is the most important part of this art, and we should definitely take it to other parts of the country. We could have this as a brand, Goa Affordable Art Fest, and this can become Bombay Affordable Art Fest, and Mumbai Affordable Art Fest, and Delhi Affordable Art Fest, and Bangalore Affordable Art Fest, and it will definitely happen.
So you're looking at opening a few more museum of Goa's all across the country?
Not museum of Goa. I definitely feel that I would like to open, because that is my life's mission now. I'm not doing this thing to earn exactly my living. I'm already 58 and whatever that I have already done. So for me, it is important to take art to the masses. That's the mission. See, to put it in very simple words, I would like to be the Tukaram of contemporary art. What did Tukaram do? Tukaram took the wisdom of Vedas to the masses in the language of the masses. And that's what is the importance of Tukaram. And he was sort of the higher caste people did not encourage him. So here, what we have to do is we have to become Tukarams of contemporary art and take it to everybody. I want to even create a truck, for example, which will go to villages, and we will be able to see show contemporary works of art on a large screen to the people. So I definitely hope that this will be a great success, and this will be not just one of its kind, but it will be a yearly event.
Okay, so why do you feel today in Goa we lack good art education? And in fact, the Goa Affordable Art Fest got a very poor response from Goan artists, and not many applications from the Goa College of Art, which has quite a number of students. So why do you think the selection team was unable to actually select these Goan artists? Is there something lacking in their artwork, which you feel is because of the schooling system in India?
Okay. You asked me two questions. Yeah. I mean, one thing I would say that, see, I believe that there are about 25 very, very good artists in Goa. I love their work. And I feel they have great, great potential. I don't want to name everybody because I name one, somebody else is unhappy, but they are very good artists. But I must also say that there is something which is called Sushagad mode, and many of them lack that killing instinct or drive, because everybody has a home, everybody knows that they will get their own the meals at least are provided, and so there's a little bit of laziness. Because I mean, when we announced a prize in memory of my father, I announced a prize of 1 lakh rupees for the emerging Goan artist. And how many applications do I get? I get only 30 applications. So there is a little Sushagad mode which needs to be changed, because unless you really go passionately after it, it doesn't work. But at the same time, I must also tell you that this land, this soil has created great artists we have Vasudev Gaitonde, Francis Newton Souza, two artists who have sold their work for the highest price in whole of country. Both of them are from Goa. Yeah. And if you see, music, then the whole galaxy of musicians come, singers and musicians come from here. Yeah? Yeah. So Goa has something in the soil which nurtures artists. A little bit of more hard work is necessary, and I'm sure they will do it. Now, talking about art education,
what do you think can what do you think the government can do to improve the art institutions in Goa, and also promote more contemporary art? Maybe change the syllabi a little, and improve the system basically.
Yeah. So talking about the art college, I think the syllabi which is taught in most art colleges, I'm not just saying Goa Art College, yeah, most art colleges is outdated. Because when I wanted to send you to an art school, I checked up, of course. I am not a business tycoon that I can afford to send my son to London. But I felt a need that you should go to the best of institution, because you deserved it. And then I found that most of the institutions in India lack that quality. And that is because the syllabi is outdated. They are still having sculpture department and painting department and graphic department. This is all outdated thing. Art does not have caste. Art cannot be compartmentalized. So that is the reason. So syllabi needs to be changed, and the basic also the thinking process needs to be opened up. Like for example, when I interact with the art teachers in other parts of the world, I find that some of them are not great artists themselves. You need not be a great artist to be a great teacher, because sometimes a teacher has to give the student something which he does not have. Yeah. That's what I learned. My father was a timid man, but made me bold, made me confident. So good teachers have to give something which they don't have, and recognize the talent in the students and feel proud of the students. That's very, very important. And so I think, first of all, the syllabi has to change and the thinking process has to change. And this can only happen when they demolish the syllabi and make it open.
How do you think the government can intervene to, change this?
Yeah, the government is, education is a state subject. So if the state decides that, okay, we have to change the syllabi, they can also do it very easily. But whoever is the education minister has to realize that, okay, I do not understand this subject. Let me appoint an authority on this and then do this. So this is the problem which is happening in the art field, even in selecting public art. Public art is selected by MLAs or some IS officers or some ministers. Now, they are not qualified to do it. They have no business. If you have a heart problem, you don't go to the secretary health, or you don't go to the minister health. You go to a heart surgeon or a heart physician. So same way, if you need to set up a sculpture in town, you have to go to a curator, to a proper artist.
Absolutely.
So that has to happen. Thinking process has to change. See, basically, I am an optimist, and I am sure this will happen, and we will see definitely a great art movement in Goa.
Yeah, thank you very much.